wife, mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, aunt, and a friend to all that knew her. Mary was proud of her Slovenian heritage and was a wonderful cook. We will miss her stuffed cabbage, chicken paprikash, kibasi and sauerkraut, and her Hungarian cookies, just to mention a few items. We will miss her presence at the head of the Sunday dinner table, doling out advice, always unsolicited, and telling stories of her childhood and life that span 100 years. Mary was a devout Catholic and a lifelong member of Holy Cross Church, of which she was so proud. Mary devoted herself to the Blessed Mother and even tended a garden in the yard dedicated to Mary. Mary touched so many lives through her personal and professional life. She was like a grandmother slash advisor to many Fairfield University students and faculty over 50 years. She was so beloved on campus that she was elected as Student of the Year by the Senate in 2009, an honor which she cherished. Mary experienced many hardships in her life, especially the loss of her husband, daughter, and grandson. Although these were difficult times for Mary, it was her faith in God and being surrounded by her loving family and friends that helped her get through. Mary had a personal motto, quote, "If you don't use it, you're going to lose it," end quote. And she lived her daily life by this credo. Mary would set a daily project or goal to fulfill, and most of the time, she would complete the task at the end by day's end. Mary also indulged in a daily bowl of ice cream, which seemed to be one of the key factors to her health and longevity, along with watching many daily masses on television, and of course, getting her law degree by watching Judge Judy daily. Mary loved gardening, butterflies, being outside of her beautiful yard, sitting on the patio, company, and just enjoying nature around her. Mary loved to have family and friends visit and spend time with her. She especially loved teasing and joking with her second son, Billy Chassar. Mary was so proud of her family and loved them all so much. She especially lit up when surrounded by her grandchildren and great-grandchildren who brought her such love and joy in her later life. It's not easy living 100 years when most, if not all, of your family and friends have predeceased you, but Mary lived her life with much love and compassion. Many times over the last several months, Mary had shared with me that she was tired, and she was ready to go home to be with the Lord and her loved ones. How do you pay tribute to a woman who lived a good long life and left an imprint on every heart that she touched? It's called love.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears
told many were just like him, it was me. think this is where the bond between Mitzi and I strengthened. We shared so many memories together with Pop. I think that some of that later on, when I lost my mom, Mitzi's oldest daughter, we could relate to each other. We shared tears, happy stories, and love for my mom. I knew that she got me, and she knew that I got her. Many of the losses were all her losses were also mine. My entire life, she always knew how to make it better. She always, always, always had my back. For 52 years, I had an incredibly strong, very determined woman in my corner. And for that, I am extremely grateful. I will miss her advice, her comforting words, her voice, and I will miss her singing me happy birthday for the rest of my life. I do find comfort in the knowledge that she's reunited with my mom, my brother, and her brothers and sisters. And I will surely miss her for the rest of my days. I'll always remember the lessons that I learned from my grandmother, the importance of faith, the strength of family, and the serenity of nature, especially admiring the beauty of the forest.
I come to the garden alone, while the dew is still on the roses, and the voice I hear falling on my ear, the Son of God discloses. Talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever. I'd stay in the garden with him, though the night around me is falling, but he bids me go through the voice of hope, his voice to me is calling, and he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry. Has ever known, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known.
Video, video.